It was a great performance by CSA. It kind of had everything from sword fights to a cow to lead clips. I mean, what else could you ask for?
I don't know about you, but I was really impressed by their background and that campus.
So next up, we have the Black Student Union with their skit about a wedding between an African-American and a West African, Ghanaian to be specific. The mothers of the bride and the groom are still arguing about their cultural differences and are unsure if their children have chosen the right spouse. The children are emphatic that they chose correctly and show everyone why during the actual wedding. After the wedding, there's a reception where, through food and music, the two families become integrated. Let's hear it for BSU.
Saying this ever since she told me she was getting married to a foreigner. I just think they're too different for this to work. I want my grandchildren to grow up with the ideals of our culture.
That's unfair. What about my culture? Why shouldn't our grandchildren learn about my culture?
This is a standard example of diaspora wars. Here we have an African-American family and a Ghanaian family preparing for their wedding. The two mothers have had arguments about their cultures. For those that don't know, Ghana is a country located in West Africa, between Togo and Cote d'Ivoire. Major staples of Ghanaian food include jollof rice, fufu, and amutua. Ghanaian dances include the Azonto and the Akaida. Some famous Ghanaians include wrestler Kofi Kingston and the late soccer player Christian Atsu. Back to the topic at hand. Much like other countries, weddings are a pretty big deal in Ghana. There are different customs and traditions, such as the Ajwa dance and the offering of drinks to the father, and one more. I'm sure you know all about African American culture, but although Black culture has taken influence from Africa, it has a lot of its own features. Black people have created almost every music genre, from blues to country to rock, and of course, rap. Popular foods include collard greens, cornbread, mac and cheese, and grits. Popular dances include the Dougie, the Jerk, and breakdancing. Black wedding traditions include jumping the broom and the libation ceremony. That brings us to where we are now. Everyone claims that their culture is the best. My jollof rice is better, my music is better, my traditional garments are better, my culture is better, and on and on. All these arguments accomplish nothing, but hey, I guess it is human nature to compete and people want bragging rights. I wonder if these guys can resolve their conflicts in time for the wedding, or maybe someone will be left at the altar. I guess we'll find out.
Your daughter has been nothing but a distraction for my son.
Distraction? It's your son that's been the distraction. My daughter's always spending time with your son instead of focusing on her work.
I see. What does your daughter even do? My son needs to marry a doctor or a lawyer. He will not be spending time working just so your daughter can steal all his money. I kept telling my son that he should look for someone like his brother's wife. She is smart and an independent physician.
My daughter is a fashion designer, and I'll have you know that she makes very good money in her job. She doesn't need to be a doctor or whatever to make a living.
Is that so?
I don't appreciate you guys talking about me like I'm not right here. Can you guys give it a break?
I agree with Adrian. Mothers, can we please take a break from all this fighting? Tomorrow is the wedding, and your children need you guys to support them on their big day. How about we take a few hours to cool off and come back to finish preparing?
A few moments later.
Okay, everyone, welcome back. I hope everyone had time to cool off. Ladies, do you have anything you'd like to say to each other?
I don't have anything to say to her. Okay, fine. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said all those mean things about you and your son. For one thing, if my daughter has been with your son for all this time, I'm sure he's the one for her.
I would also like to apologize for the things I said. Like you said, if our children choose each other, we as their parents should trust their decision and do our best to make this family into one big family.
Thank you all for joining us on this day to celebrate the love of this young man and woman. It's a monumental moment in their lives, and we are happy to see this young couple, and we wish them all the best. I hope there aren't any objections to this marriage. Seeing none, without further ado, let us get on with this ceremony. Do the wife and groom have any vows they would like to say?
In Chi, there's a common proverb. It says, in English, this means, "This reminds me of the trials and tribulations that we have gone through. I know that some members of my bride-to-be's family don't think that I'm the right man for this woman, but I promise that I love her with my whole heart and would do anything for this beautiful woman."
What touching words from our groom. Does the wife have anything she would like to say?
I remember on our first date when you taught me how to say I love you in Chi. I still say medowo to him all the time. I know that when we have kids, I'll help as much as I can to make sure that they can speak the language.
Wow. Do you take this woman to be your lovely wife?
I do.
Do you take this man to be your husband?
I do.
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Arguments earlier, but I'm happy to see that these two crossed paths and it all worked out in the end.
Enjoy the food and refreshments, and I hope everyone in here has a good time.
Hey, I want to say something too. Just wanted to reiterate what he said. I know that Americans know how to get down, but now I see that Ghanaians know how to get down too. I am glad that we were able to be a part of this wedding and learn more about a new culture. Now, let's get back to dancing.